right, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me a great pleasure to welcome Dino Cazares from Fear Factory, Asesino, Divine Heresy, and probably the band that you're listening to right now is influenced by Dino. What's going on, Dino? How are you, brother?
I'm doing good. I'm just over here in sunny California, talking to you.
Hey, man, a new record is in the works. Can you give us a quick update of when people can expect to listen to the music and what's going on with that?
The record is done. The record's been done. The record will be out August 7th. You're exclusively hearing that right now. August 7th, and the record is called GENEXUS.
GENEXUS, and what inspired that name?
Okay, GENEXUS is it's Genesis and Nexus together. And Genesis is obviously the beginning of time, and Nexus is things coming together. So it's a combination of where we started from the beginning and where we are now, and just those things coming together. It's a full conceptual album, which we can get into that some other time. But for right now, it's coming out August 7th, and it's called GENEXUS.
Hell yeah, man. And it's coming out through Nuclear Blast Entertainment, which means you're back working with Monty Connor. Why don't you tell us how that has helped, you know, the band to kind of, you know, go to the next level? Because Fear Factory has done so much, has a huge legacy, but you guys are always, you know, looking for that next level. I know you are.
you know, well, I always, you know, try to, you know, look for the next thing, go to the next level. And definitely going to Nuclear Blast Entertainment was the next level for us. You know, Monty Connor originally signed the band, you know, back in 1991, on Roadrunner Records. So when he left there and went to Nuclear Blast and realized that we were available, he definitely approached the band, and it's been a great pleasure working with Monty again. I feel like we got the old team back, you know, you know, everything's worked out great so far.
Hell yeah. Now, how many new songs are going to be on the new record?
Ah, look at you. You're asking a lot of questions right away. there's going to be 10 songs on the record, and of course there will be special packaging with bonus tracks, and of course vinyl with bonus tracks as well.
Right, because vinyl seems to be, for the last 5 years or so, the hottest commodity. Everybody wants vinyl all of a sudden again.
Yeah, I've been putting out vinyl for the last, since the beginning of my career. You know, you can find Soul of a New Machine, D-Manufacture, on vinyl. You know, you can find all that stuff on vinyl. Some of the remanufactured stuff came out on vinyl. D-Manufacture was on vinyl. You know, we've been putting out vinyl for a long time. But, you know, ever since I came back into Fear Factory, we've always put out Fear Factory on vinyl.
Since you came back to Fear Factory, why don't you tell us about how the relationship with Burton is going? Because, you know, last time I saw you guys, everything was really peachy, really cool. Is it still like that? Are you guys still, like, working as brothers?
Yeah, of course. I mean, you know, I've known Burton for so long. You know, obviously he lives in Pennsylvania. I live here in California. So we don't get to see each other a lot, but we talk to each other on the phone a lot. Obviously, when we were making the record, you know, we were around each other all the time. And it's kind of cool when we're making a record because it reminds me of when we first started, you know, because every time we make a record and it's like, okay, we got to make another record. What are we going to do? We talk about what the plan is. And then, boom, once we focus, you know, once we had song titles, once we had, you know, somewhat of a concept, what we were going to sing about, all the music and everything started to come into place. So those moments that I have with him are very, very exciting. Because, you know, both of our creative process, you know, is working. And when both of our creative process connect, when we connect on music, lyrics, and concept, those are the best moments that I have with them, creating stuff like that.
Right. It's like you guys answer each other's questions with music, you know? That's the way I see the chemistry between you guys.
Kind of, yeah. Because the minute I throw a riff down, he's like, oh, I got it. You know what I mean? He's got an idea right away, you know what I mean? So, you know, in that way we connect really well, you know what I mean? And, of course, outside of that we do as well, too. On a professional level we connect really well, and on a friendship level, you know, we connect very well. So everything's, you know, in case the world wants to know how we get along great.
And this time around you had Mike Heller record the drums very fast, and you guys are going back to, like, you know, actually using drums and not the drum machine. So that's, I think the sonic quality is probably different because of that.
Yeah, it gives it more of a natural feeling. Definitely more of a natural feeling. But obviously, when you start recording, you can obviously, you know, add sounds, and you can, you know, manipulate the sounds any way you want it to sound like. So obviously, we kind of, you know, it's kind of a hybrid between organic and digital. That's what this record sounds like, and I think that's what makes it sound really good. You know, albums like Demanufacture and Obsolete were, you know, the same type of hybrid, and that's what that was the approach that we took on the drums on this record. Also, Dean Castronovo, the drummer of Journey, actually played on one of the tracks on the album.
Oh, that's pretty cool, man. And now you have Tony on bass. Was he involved during the recording sessions, or he just came into the band recently?
Just came into the band recently. We were pretty much already done with the record, and we were in February. We went to Australia to play this festival called the Soundwave Festival,
right?
And there is where Ministry was playing on the same festival, so we got to hang out a lot. And you know, Tony found out that Matt DeVries wasn't going to be playing with us very much any longer because, you know, he wanted to focus on his family. So Tony found out and straight away asked me, he goes, "Hey man, what's going on? Like, I heard Matt's going to be leaving." I'm like, "Yeah, oh my God." You know, it's like he's right in front of me, and like, why didn't I even think to ask him? You know what I mean? Maybe because, you know, he was doing it with Soulfly or something, you know, but, you know, so when he asked me, I'm like, "You're in. You don't have to audition. I mean, what are you going to do about your other bands?" And he goes, "Well, you know, Ministry's done, and Ministry's going to be done soon. And I really want to play with you, man." And I'm like, "Okay, fuck, you're in. That's it." That's how quick it was decided.
I mean, I guess the stars aligned for you guys. I mean, because obviously you guys have worked in Asesino together, but, you know, there's going to be, like, another cool project for you guys to, you know, take to the next level, as we said before.
Well, you know, Tony's been a friend of mine since way back, back in the what I call the backyard days, because the backyard days was when his band, they were called Dominion, my band, Fear Factory, we were doing backyard shows, backyard gigs here in East L.A., in South Central Los Angeles, you know, back when we were, you know, our early teens, you know, 19, 20, 20, 21 years old, doing these shows. And so I knew him from way back then. And then when he joined Static X, we took Static X on their first tour in the U.S., Fear Factory did. And then, obviously, you know, we do Asesino together. So we've been friends for quite a long time, and it's like having my own brother in the band. You know, that's how close and that's how tight we are. And obviously he knows the style. I mean, he was in Static X, you know, it's like had a lot of similar style to Fear Factory. And, you know, obviously, you know, playing in bands like Ministry and Soulfly and Cavalier Conspiracy and Prong, you know, he's definitely a bass player that can pretty much adapt to whatever, you know, you throw at him, whatever band it is, he can pretty much adapt to it. And obviously he's in Asesino, which is my other project, which is pretty extreme. And so I already know that he can handle the picking style. So it's all good. You know, it works out perfect.
Hell yeah. When we talked to him recently, he was telling me that he hopes that when you guys got some downtime from touring that you can work in some Asesino songs.
A lot of people ask me about that. "Oh, shit, now you guys are together. Great. New Asesino coming soon?" You know. Yeah, that's one of the cool things is, like, you know, when we were, you know, when he was doing all his other bands and I was, you know, doing Fear Factory, we never could find time to do the next Asesino record. So now that we're together, we're going to be together a lot, we can finish writing the album, the next Asesino record. So, you know, we'll definitely have a lot of time on the road to do that.
Oh, hell yeah,
so we're excited about we're excited. I want that record to come out too. It's been, the last record came out, what, 2007? That's a long time.
Time yeah. Flies, man. Time flies. And what about Divine Heresy? Because, you know, there were some rumors that they were going to come back without you. And I'm like, hey, that's Dino's band. So what's going on with your Divine Heresy, the real Divine Heresy?
Well, at the moment, it's on the back burner still. I mean, now that... You know, we got a new Fear Factory record coming out. Obviously, a lot of attention is going to be on that. You know, and then Tony's in the band. Now I'm going to be able to finish another Asesino record. So as soon as all that stuff's done, I'll be able to do the next Divine Heresy.
It's all about finding the time, right?
It's all about finding the time, exactly.
And this week you guys announced a tour with Cold Chamber, which I think it's going to be a badass tour. A lot of people are saying, oh, why are you guys going to be opening for Cold Chamber? But I think it makes sense because both bands come from like the same cloth in a way.
They asked us to be on the tour. And so, you know, we have no problem supporting our friends, our brothers. You know, Miguel, also another Mexicano on the tour, you know. You know, I've known Cold Chamber since the local scene in L.A., I helped them get signed to Roadrunner Records back in 1996, I'm sorry. And, you know, so I've always been a part of that, you know, a part of their, you know, beginning of how they got started. And, we, you know, we have no problem supporting them, you know, and it's going to be a fun tour. I can't wait. You know, we all know the guys really well. You know, they know Tony really well. They know Bert really well. So, it's you know, we know Jamie Joseph for years. So it's kind of like all of our friends, you know, touring together.
Yeah, the after parties are going to be pretty wild, man.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. You know, we'll see how that goes.
Just make sure you guys make it to the next show. That's the only thing that matters.
Well, you're going to see us when we're in New York, right?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Well, by that time, by the time we hit New York, you'll have I don't know what the date is off the top of my head, but you will have already heard at least two new Fear Factory songs.
Oh hell yeah! So you guys are gonna play some new songs while on this tour?
No, we're gonna release some singles. Well, we might play some new songs on the tour, yeah, but definitely we're gonna release a single, a couple of singles.
Excellent, man. And before we got out of here, a lot of your colleagues, a lot of our friends in the music industry have been writing books about their experience in the music industry. I know you've been through a lot of good things, a lot of great things, a lot of some negative things. Any plans of writing the Dino Cazares book at some point?
would you read it?
Oh, hell yeah.
I'd have to put two different versions out, one in English, the other one in Spanish.
Yeah.
You know, I've had a few people, my web guy actually asked me if I wanted to do that and that he would help me put it together. But I don't know, man. There'd be a lot of nasty stuff in there.
You'll piss a lot of people off.
A lot of modernismo will be in there.
Oh, man.
I mean, because that was a big part of my life. Trust me.
All right, Dino, brother, I want to thank you so much, man.
I want to thank you. And remember, you're the first person to know this right now.
So. Yeah, man, I appreciate it. We'll bless this out. And for everybody listening, yeah, you have the exclusive New Fear Factor album is coming out very soon. As everything in life.
August 7th.
Well, August 7th. When you wait for things, it's even better. It's more exciting. So it'll be worth your time for sure.
Fuck yeah. I can't wait for everybody to hear it. It's groovy. It's as groovy as Obsolete and all the energy from D Manufacturers on this record. So it's got a mixture of both.
All right, Dino, brother. Muchas gracias, man.
Thank you very much.